flesh. And those who are born of the spirit, they're spirit. So how do I fit in here? Because when the spirit comes into me, God help me, I'm a new creature. I am what we call born again. So now Jesus, since I'm in him, he was born of the spirit for me. God help me. So when I come in him and I receive the Holy Ghost, God sees me as his child. The Bible said Jesus gives us the power to be the sons of God. So when I receive the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit bears witness with my spirit that I'm God's child. Somebody say amen to this. That I'm God's child. Just want to give you an attitude right now. I don't care who rejected you and what they said about you. If you understand that you have been born of the spirit, God sees you as a child. You already have inheritance right now because of Jesus. Because he sees you through him. It got quiet. Am I helping you all?
Yes.
Am I really helping you?
Yes.
You see how important you are? You are God's own child. Yes. Boy, this thing is going to change. If you get it, it's going to change the attitude. It's going to make you be like how I was when Obama first went to presidency. I walked in the gym with a... Y'all not going to talk to me, huh? Oh yeah, I walked in the gym that next day was fine. What's up? Yeah, we got this. So, I just need to tell that dad, what's up? I'm God's child. What you help me with? What can you do to me? What is that yellow already not prepared me for? You already have all things. So I'm not gonna get it. I was gonna try to get into how this inheritance works. We'll do that next week. I think it's enough meat for the day. Do you understand? It's a lot, isn't it? Do you understand who you are? See, it's one thing for people to tell you, but when the book shows you and the Holy Spirit explains it to you, it gives you an attitude. Glory to God. I expect it to happen for me. I'm just not quoting scriptures anymore. I expect it to happen. It's my right, it's my illness. I'm God's own child. The Spirit bears witness with my spirit. And only heard about the only thing he's going to deal with me on is promises. Amen. Boy, that's awesome.
Yes.
The eulogy on my life, Hugh, is what God promised me.
Yes.
Can I close this for you? See, he gives you a eulogy, and then he speaks a benediction. When God says to you, you are healed with my stripes, that's a benediction.
Amen.
Ain't no discussion about that. He already told you, you are healed with my stripes. Go ahead. You gotta believe though. And then you gotta be processed into this. So once he told me that all things are working together for my good, that's a benediction. So it don't feel like it right now, but I got a benediction on my life. I'm out here by myself. I'm out here by myself. Do I have anybody who won't believe? He told me, Charles, all things work together for good. Because you love me and you're the call according to my purpose. So even though you're in jail, it's still working for good.
Yes, sir.
Because that's the benediction on all things in my life. He barely spoke this on my life. All things don't work together for good. What are you going through? That you think somebody done stabbed you in the back, or somebody done hurt your feelings, or somebody done rejected you, and you can't see your way out, and you can't see your way clear. Can you believe the benediction of God? As a child, see, this is where we decide who grew up and who don't.
Yeah, yeah.
Can you open your mouth and say, this is going to be working, this is working together for my good?
Yes.
Tears coming down my face, but it's working together for my good.
Yes.
Don't know what I'm going to do about it tomorrow, but it's working together for my good. It looks like they're coming to take my car, but it's working together for my good. Oh, y'all ain't ready to think. All things, that's the benediction of God. That's a benediction, Q. His final thought on the things in your life that they're all going to work together for good.
Amen.
Can you believe that? Stand up, please. I tried to follow these notes because I had some good stuff in here, but here, here. As you stand, you turn to Galatians chapter 4, and I'm going to close with this for you. I'm reading verse 28. I'm going to show you. See, because sometimes you don't want to believe the preacher. 28. Listen to this carefully.
brethren, as Isaac was, are the children of promise.
God help me. They don't get that. No, don't read no more. Now we brethren, church folk, as Isaac was, are the children of promise. Y'all ain't got it. They don't want to get it. Let me say it again. Now we brethren, me, you, as Isaac was, we are the children of promise. Which means that we're here by promise and for promises. And God's only going to deal with us on promises. And every promise that he put in the book is a eulogy. Everyone he speaks to you is when God said he gave you worldwide ministry. That's a eulogy. Why are you going to walk away from that? God, I'm going to host that kid. You again, so. I'm going to hear by myself. I feel like I'm going to hear by myself. Now we, brethren, as Isaac was, are the children of promise. Which means that God is only going to deal with me on his promise. Why do you judge my life? He's watching his promise. He said, I will hasten my work. I am to perform it. So while the devil's fighting me, and while I feel hopeless, he's still dealing with me on promise. And he gave me some instructions that you be not slothful. I feel the Holy Ghost. But be followers of them who do faith and patience. Lord, God, somebody say patience. Inherit the promises. I'm going to leave this with y'all. I'm picking up next week. Listen, what God promised is something to wonder. Yeah. Many of us don't walk in it because we don't have patience. Yeah. The word patience means to endure the time and the seasons God keeps in his own power. Yes. God, this is good. He promised it to you. And if you look, the Bible says, what things are written four times, they're written for our learning. So that we can patience and come from the scripture. But I know that's why he told us about David. That's why he told us about Abraham. He tells us about these people and let us know. It might take a while. Glory to God. But if you believe what I say, you will endure the contradictions. You will endure the hardships and the heartaches. You will endure the embarrassment that people talking about you. You will endure what the devil tells you. The Bible says Jesus endured the cross. For the joy that was set before him, because he had a promise. Who am I talking to in here?
Everybody.
You are God's child. Amen. What he promised you, he's going to do. Amen. You got to, and we're going to be talking about this for a minute, because I didn't get to my real message. We have to understand that what God, see, this is what I want to get. See, let me let y'all go. I want to raise up a church. And God is doing it. He's just using me. That's why I get these revelations.
Amen.
That's why I tell you, I don't call nobody. I don't invite nobody to church. That's your altar. I'm going to preach to who God sent. Because he promised me what's going to happen with gender love. And I can endure this. Glory to God. Oh, come on. I can endure this. For the joy that's been set before me. I don't have to compromise. I don't got to change my rules. I don't got to change my vision. I don't have to do none of that no more. Because I'm not counting on my ability to preach to get it done. I'm not counting on my leadership ability. I'm counting on the promise of God. I'm the Holy Ghost to bring it to pass. So if I have a bad day, keep me lifted up. I'm not going to compromise myself just to keep you happy. Understand that. But I wish some of y'all would get like that.
Yes.
People who are joined to you will never leave you.
Yes.
They might leave for a season. Hallelujah. Oh yeah, oh yeah. If they join to you, but there's a law for that. I'm going to help somebody with that. It says they met up from us because they were not of us. Because had they been of us, no doubt they would have continued with us. But they met up from us. That it might be made manifest in none of us.
Yes.
People leave you because they're not joined to you.
Amen.
And there are people who are going to leave for a season. And my wife told you on Wednesday night, sometimes I was gone for seasons.
Yes.
Yeah, but I was joined to her. And no matter how much she didn't want it at times, and how much I didn't want it at times, God already joined us together. Y'all ain't talking to me here. No matter how we signed up our papers twice, but God's already joined us together. Y'all ain't gonna stay with me because y'all can't stand this kind of faith.
Amen.
But God put us together and said, I've given y'all a model marriage.
Amen.
After all the crap we went through, look at what we have today. Oh, y'all ain't talking to me here. See, I'm just giving you a testimony because all of we both had a lot of reasons to leave.
Yes.
But because we were joined together, couldn't leave.
Amen.
I'm helping somebody with this. They might go for a reason. They might go for a season.
That's true.
But if they join you, I feel the Holy Ghost. God will torment them.
Oh, yeah.
See, let me tell you something. I'm going to comfort you right here. The reason why God put you through process is because people have to be prepared.